There are so many individuals in the world today who are good at making money but lack knowledge about how to sustain it. Even if you earn little, with the right knowledge, that little can become a fortune. In this video, I will show you 9 things financial literates know about money that you probably do not. 1. Money can work for you. Money is energy, and energy wants to move. So sitting money is dead money. With this in mind, sitting on a large amount of money and just having it collect dust in your checking account is a guaranteed way to lose money, as inflation will be whittling away at your savings. While there are times when sitting on a pile of liquid capital is a smart choice, but by and large, you want your money making money for you. Anyone who has spent even an hour learning about investment strategy has likely heard the term compound interest. This is when you invest money. The addition of interest to the original amount of funds occurs on top of the principal amount, and then you earn interest on the principal sum plus the interest. This effect compounds with time, and you make money on top of your earned money. Financial literates know that investment are the best ways to make money work for you. 2. Money grows on trees. While growing up as kids, there's a statement that many of our parents used to tell us, money does not grow on trees. Well, the truth is that money does grow on trees. Maybe not in a literal way, but money grows on trees. The issue is that just like most people value their money more than their time, the majority of people also think in too short of a timeline. They want to get rich quick. They want investment opportunities that will make them instant millionaires. They want to know how to start businesses that can generate crazy amounts of cash from day one. But things do not work like that. Every money at hand is a seed. When you plant a seed, does it begin to bear fruit just overnight? Of course not. Money is like a seed that ought to be planted and nurtured so that in due time, it will become a tree and produce more money. The hard work, time, patience, and other resources invested are the necessary things used for nurturing. Financially literate individuals would instead grow money than seek for other ways to pluck from someone else's tree. As Corner Obest of Bright Eyes fame once sang, I'd rather be working for a paycheck than waiting to win the lottery. 3. There is no shortage of money. American author Grant Cardone once said, there is no shortage of money, only a shortage of people thinking big enough. Well, you may be in doubt about Grant's statement, but it's the truth. The quote by Grant is backed by Law of Abundance, one of the laws of money which states that we live in an abundant universe in which there is plenty of money available for those who want it, providing that they are willing to do what it takes to get it. The emergence and widespread of digital currency in this era shows even more that Grant was not talking trash when he said there is no shortage of money. Financial literates know that even though they are broke at the moment, and even though a country has been declared to be in recession, there is enough for anyone who wants it. Thus, they put the power of desire, knowledge, and faith as suggested by Napoleon Hill in Think and Grow Rich to get money. 4. Emergency funds help you save money. A recent study found that only 1 in 3 millennials has enough money saved for a single emergency room visit or a car repair. Forget about covering rent and food in case of a job loss. If you leave yourself with no cushion, just one unexpected expense can send you into debt that might end up following you around for years and even impact your relationships. So, while your 20s might be a great time to invest in your skills and experiences with travel, grad school, and other worthwhile expenses, you must preserve enough cash for worst-case scenarios. How much? Experts suggest making sure you save enough money to cover between 3 and 6 months' worth of living expenses. 5. Time is more important than money. People with unhealthy money mindsets disproportionately overvalue their cash and undervalue their time. Don't be so married to holding onto your precious dollars at all cost, and be more aware of how you invest your time on a day-to-day basis. If you don't like a book you're reading, stop reading it. If you can't stand the movie you're watching, leave the theater. If you find yourself feeling wholly drained after hanging out with your friends, and this has been a pattern for months or even years, then change your social circle. Bulk buy certain things that you know you will be using long-term, toilet paper, toothpaste, salt, etc. Again, not for the dollar savings as much as the time you save by not having to go pick it up whenever you run out. Your time matters. You can always make more money, but you can't generate more time. So treat it as the precious commodity that it is. 6. Debt is surmountable if you don't get into it. 2 out of every 5 millennials has credit card debt, and a similar proportion has student debt also, or instead. Student debt can be manageable if you start tackling it soon after graduation. Once you start working, some programs can help reduce your burden, both in terms of monthly payments and if you work in a qualifying field, in terms of the overall balance. credit card debt, on the other hand, may feel particularly inescapable. If you struggle to pay even the minimum each month, it can be incredibly discouraging to watch the interest you owe grow and grow. Financial literates know that the best way to live a debt-free life is to not get into debts in the first place. As much as you can, it would help if you try to avoid situations that will put you in debt. Learn the rule of, if I can't pay for it now, or I don't have a source that can help me pay in installments, then I should not get the item now. The only exceptions you should have are for things that would bring gains to you, such as student loan. 7. A building is not always an investment. You may have heard that investing in real estate can earn high returns, but remember that there's a difference between investing in the real estate sector, say by purchasing an investment property that you rent out for a profit, and buying a home to live in. Well-maintained home in a desirable neighborhood certainly can increase in value, but transaction costs will likely counteract with any gains if you don't live in the house for at least 5 years. Plus, most homes won't appreciate quickly enough to beat inflation by more than a reasonable amount of that. So, unless you plan to rent out a part of your house to generate income, don't assume your home is going to be a killer investment, even if it's a lovely place to live. 8. You can begin to plan your taxes as soon as you can. Tax strategy is a method which ensures that you are paying as little tax as possible. In this way, you can free up as much money as you can for expense and investment purposes. There are tax benefits that you can begin to use as soon as you graduate from college. For example, there is a tax benefit that indicates you can reduce the expenses that you incur when moving due to a job as long as you move more than 50 miles from your current address. Other tax benefits allow you to receive 50% of the first $1,000 that you put aside for retirement annually. Financially intelligent individuals learn about these tax methods in advance and use them to their advantage. 9. The money you make matters. The money you save matters. An often passed around sentiment is that it's not about how much you make, it's about how much you save. And while this is a valuable advice for a good percentage of the world that overspends and live beyond their means, it isn't either or equation, but rather a both or and. Yes, saving money matters, but so does your income. For example, an expert saver who makes $20,000 per year will generally not keep as well as someone who is an okay saver who makes $500,000 per year. The income you generate through your work is essential, and so is how much of that you can hold on to and invest. Both sides of this equation requires effort and discipline. It can require effort to let go of your mental blocks to money and fail to put in the effort that allows you to call money into your life. For people who are good with money, it's not about always having the latest and greatest or even having huge incomes or bank accounts. It's about good habits.